Very early in the morning, relatives of David Chani Jamwa were camped at Luzira main prison gate, waiting to receive him. Jamwa, a former NSSF boss who was jailed for causing the government a financial loss of 3 billion shillings, was yesterday pardoned by the head of state, President Yoweri Museveni. Among those that turned up to receive him was his mother, Tezra Jamwa, son Riz Remo Jamwa, among others.
But also God's own time. God's time is always the best.
These patiently waited for him to walk out of the prison's gate before welcoming him with jubilations. Addressing the media after his release, Jamwa thanked President Museveni for being merciful and accepting to pardon him amongst the thousands of people in prison.
It's kindness, sympathy, and mercy. And I'm head over heels, ecstatic is the right word. And we'll continue thanking him and thanking his establishment.
Jamwa confessed that the few years he has been incarcerated have been very challenging, but he has managed to learn a few lessons. He hopes to once again contribute positively to the country's development now that he has been released.
No, it's not easy. Yeah. It's difficult, but it's also character building. So there are two sides to that coin. It's an experience that changes you.
Tezra Jamwa, the mother of David Chandi Jamwa, also thanked the president for accepting to pardon her son, who has been incarcerated for close to 5 years.
I'm just delighted that finally God Almighty has answered our prayers, we as the family and friends. And I also want to thank His Excellency the President for having that fatherless spirit, for having signed that prerogative of mercy to have David Chandi Jamwa released. So we are just excited and we thank God for His goodness, for His presence.
He's a family man. He puts a lot of emphasis on family and teaches us a lot of values that are important. So it has been extremely difficult going without him, but even when he was there, he has still endeavored to be in our lives and present and keeps giving his guiding hand over us. So we'd just like to thank God, of course, first of all, and thank His Excellency, our President, for the pardon. And we just can't wait to have him home and to have him settled as soon as possible.
Jamwa has been serving a 12-year jail sentence for causing a financial loss to the National Social Security Fund, NSSF. He was indicted by the High Court on the 2 counts of abuse of office and causing financial loss contrary to the Anti-Corruption Act of 2009. He was tried and convicted of the offences of causing financial loss but was acquitted of the offence of abuse of office. He was then sentenced to 12 years imprisonment and barred from holding any public office for a period of 10 years, serving the sentence. His 2 appeals in the Court of Appeal were consolidated but later dismissed. He was instead sentenced to 4 years imprisonment for the offence of abuse of office, which was to run concurrently with the 12 years imposed by the trial judge for the offence of causing financial loss. Yesterday, President Museveni pardoned him alongside 12 other people who were serving sentences on grave offences. Rachel Nachuala, reporting for the news.